wonderful teachers, the family, friends, and all of the encouraging staff here at Upward Learning. So, does it ever feel like school is just really boring? Like, I'm going to classes, I'm trying to get my homework done. It's the same old routine and feels pointless. Like you've been doing this forever and it continues, the same old routine. You've been doing it on and on, goes forever, like a downward spiral until you just feel depressed. Well, I'm here to tell you that there is in fact an end. You can still reach it. It's not as far as it seems. Oscar Wilde says, "We're all stuck in the gutter, but some of us are looking at the stars." An education is a hard thing to get, more so than just paying for it. It's hard to stay loyal to the task. Sometimes we don't like what we have to do for homework, and we don't put enough effort into it. Sometimes we avoid working altogether. I can tell you from experience, this is not the way to go. It's much easier to just finish what you're doing well than have to start over again. The things you are learning now will actually help you in the future. Sometimes the best things in life are the ones that you have to work very hard for. Math was always the subject I struggled with the most. I always had to drill really hard to remember the multiplication tables, and sometimes people would make fun of me because a fifth grader knew less than all of the third graders. When I got to algebra, I stumbled at the beginning. Many of the things just didn't make sense. It was hard. But my parents were willing to sit me down and help me work through what I was learning. I worked harder at algebra than I did at any other subject. There were even nights I dreamed about equations. And you know what? Algebra had only A's. There was a similar situation when I was learning to play the piano. My teacher began by teaching songs so that I could learn finger placement before reading notes. I would always practice a few songs each day. But there was one song I just hated, Honeydew. I don't remember why I didn't like it, but I do remember always skipping it in the book. I just didn't want to play it. So my mother had me play it twice as often as I played the other songs. Years after I quit piano, I sat down to one again, thinking it would all come back to me. The only song I remembered how to play was Honeydew. All six variations. And you know, I decided I don't really hate that song anymore. The things you truly work hard at are going to be the tools you remember the most and the ones you succeed in the most. Because you have the experience. That's what education is all about. Experiences. You get to experience equations in math, stories in English, and you get to experience people at lunch. And every experience contributes to your education. Even the experiences outside of school help shape your view of the world. So what's it all for? It's for your future. You are learning all these skills and gathering all this knowledge so that you can use it in the future. We learn history to help us understand why things are what they are today, and so we don't repeat our ancestors' mistakes. We learn English to help us speak more coherently and expand the capacity of our vocabulary. Science helps us look at the world around us and wonder, how does this work? What does that do? And the list goes on and on. We use tools from our education to do well in jobs, raise a family, and run a house. It's all important not to lose sight of this. The things you work at now or don't work at will affect your future. The future is something that has been on a lot of our minds lately. What am I going to do when I get older? Need to look at universities. What are we going to do next? Or how about this one? Am I moving next year? Most of us have lived in one or more countries. We know that the future can be a little intimidating. Leaving friends, family, the places we grew up in. Transition is hard too. New friends, new house, new cultures, and new food. That one was hard for me. The spaghetti tastes funny here, but they don't know what roti chennai is in the US. All of these experiences are part of your education too. A part that most people in the world don't get to have, and so you have a different understanding of the world than anyone else. As we all go to new places, it's important to remember that there are new opportunities out there. It was great to come to my home in my home country, and while I miss friends, things can be great in this new place. I heard this story on the radio. Once upon a time, there was a couple walking down the street. They passed by a shop and spied a beautiful teacup. They went inside for a better look, and the woman said, "Oh, it's beautiful. Look at the craftsmanship." The teacup spoke and said, "Well, you know, I wasn't always this beautiful. I used to be a lump of clay, and I was perfectly happy to be so. Then one day, the potter came and picked me up and started squishing me. He kneaded me and prodded me and cried out. I cried out, 'Stop, stop, you're hurting me.' But he softly replied, 'Not yet.' Then he put me on a table and spun me round and round and pushed me up and down, in and out. And I said, 'Stop, stop, I don't like this. I'm going to be sick.' But the potter calmly replied, 'Not yet.' Then he put me in a hot, hot oven and I cried, 'Make it stop, it hurts too much.' And the potter calmly replied, 'Not yet.' When he finally took me out of the oven and sat me down, he started smothering paint in my face. I yelled, 'Stop it! Cut it out!' But the potter simply replied, 'Not yet.' When he was finished, he put me in front of a mirror and I looked at myself. I couldn't believe it. I was beautiful. 'Is that me?' I said. 'Yes,' said the smiling potter. It is always important to remember that God is in control and that he has plans to prosper us and not to harm us. Philippians 2, verses 14 to 13 says, 'Do everything without complaining or arguing, so that you may become blameless and pure, children of God without fault in a warped and crooked generation. Then you will shine like stars in the sky as you hold firmly to the word of life. And then I will be able to boast on the day of Christ that I did not labor in vain.' Thank you."